6.
Anyway, that's how many Nox spells you hear going off at the exact same time. And now would be an excellent time for everybody to roll initiatives.
Oh, man. Wow, this got real bad real fast, huh?
Did it? Did it, though?
Well, there's 27 on this row, so that's a little under 75, plus these larger ones, so probably roughly 100.
Yeah, mine was just a ballpark estimate, looking at eyeballing the map.
Well, this is a thing. Error? Okay.
Riot, what's your action? Or what's your initiative?
My initiative is 11.
And Kelian?
16.
And Liberation?
19.
Serenity?
Serenity acts at 20.
And Mahogany?
16. Which I thought was pretty good.
The sound of 80 or 90 or whatever Nox spells going off coincides with every single door within eye shot, and you guys are, I mean, I'm going to have to shrink you down a little bit. Like, I'm going to have to shrink you down a lot, I think.
A lot bit.
Like a decent amount, yeah. Because
each of these squares is about 10 feet, give or take, so this is pretty close. Ferocity's not here.
Why not?
Places to skip in an infinite multiverse.
We look two doors down, there she is.
She's just locked up, writing her newest.
She locked herself in there.
So, let's go ahead and get a bunch of pieces here.
Oh god, here we go.
It's actually appropriate this time.
Wait, when has it ever not been appropriate?
Whenever you spawn a whole bunch of things for one dude.
I don't know.
So here's Gifod in his cell. Actually, I'm going to shrink all of these down at once. I pretty much only need the one. I can just copy-paste this one. That's fine. I really only copy-paste a million of men for effect, usually.
No. Wait,
what?
Yeah. Gasp.
So this one is going to be yellow. And this one is going to be pink. More like a fuchsia, I guess.
Magenta?
I guess it is really more magenta, isn't it? We'll make this one red. And we need one that is blue.
I'm blue.
Alright, so my first action is going to be I'm going to analyze the module to make sure that I have the right colors and then the right words for those colors.
All right, all of the doors in the wing are opened. Where are Kelian and Serenity standing at this point?
Kelian said he was in the doorway, so...
Yeah, Serenity would be, I mean...
Like, just shove yourself back in there?
Yeah.
You put him back in the corner here, it's fine. And the hallways, the mass of sobbing and hysteria and paranoia and obscenities and just gibbering spill out as all of the Barmies come forth. Very few cells don't have a Barmy in them already, and most of the cells have two. Every square we're going to treat as difficult terrain, because you have to push yourself through a mass of crazy, insane people. Very notably, a huge mass of them is coming up the stairs, trying to force their way up these spiral stairs. You hear similar hysteria echoing from the floor beneath you. And we are starting on Serenity's turn.
Move to the hallway.
Okay.
Look up and down. Do I see any of the bleakers?
No. You, other than the criminally insane, you are the only people in the wing right now.
Okay, then. Let's see. That's 15 feet of movement. What I'm going to do, let me check my inventory really quick, is pull out a length of silk rope.
Okay.
And this door right here, if I close it, does it latch?
What do you do with the Barmies that are coming out of it? Do you, like, shove them back in the cell?
Yeah, I'll try and push them back without hurting them. Just kind of shove. Yeah, not violently shove, just sort of push.
And when you shove them in and you close the door, it does latch.
All right. However many I can get, I will just start going through here and closing doors on it, along either side. So you can tell
I will
me.
Say you can do one door per turn because it's going to coincide with pushing through Barmies and shoving them into the cells.
Sure. All right, so
I recommend three doors to you.
So we're going to color this door in.
Oh, you got it.
Okay. To signify that it's closed. And this purple is just your rope that's sashaying across it.
I've just got the rope out instead of a weapon.
Okay.
That's the end of Serenity's turn.
All right, liberation.
Step out into the hallway. Let's see, that's 20 feet of movement right there.
Oh, actually, I'm sorry. I've missed a rule in my own notes here that I wrote myself and then forgot about. Serenity, go ahead and make me a strength check just to shove those Barmies into the cells. I have no doubt that you'll be able to pass this easily.
13.
All right, no problem. So that's going to be the standard check to shove Barmies into cells and close the door on them. Liberation, you're up.
I see Serenity working to do that, and I'm going to head back and head this way, do the same. I'll start, see if I can get some guys back into the cell right
okay.
there.
Go ahead and make that check.
Boop. My strength is a 10.
A 10?
Yeah.
And you shove a couple of Barmies back into the cell here and latch the door.
Cool. And, that's my turn.
A woman comes out of this cell here and she's carrying a bundle in her arms, just some soiled rags with this really rank smelling something in it. And she shoulders her way through towards Serenity. And she's saying, beseeching you, please, please help my baby. My baby is sick. We need to do something. And glancing over amidst the chaos, you can see that she's holding this incredibly thoroughly rotted melon of some kind, cradling it in her arms. But the smell of it is so unbelievably rank that Serenity, being within 10 feet of her, all attack rolls and ability checks will be made at disadvantage.
Okay.
As long as she's standing next to you. Kelian, you're up.
This situation sucks. Yeah, following Serenity and Liberation's lead, Kelian, I'll shove Barmies into cells and close them.
Okay, go ahead and make a strength check.
So, surprise, Kelian's not that great at strength. So, we'll see how this goes. that is a not great 5.
5's not going to do it. I mean, you try, but these Barmies are pushing past you. And they don't even seem to be making for the exit. There's just masses of them just moving around, but you do not get them back into that cell.
Neat. All right, and can I cunning action back into Gifad's cell over here?
Sure.
Cool.
Oh, Mahogany, what are you doing?
Really cunning with all these Barmies.
I'm going to try to flow through this situation by shape-shifting into a water elemental, shoving that woman back into her cell and locking the door.
Sorry, I have to turn my mouse cursor on. Apparently, chat's complaining about it. There, mouse cursor is visible again. So you're going to shove this woman back into her cell?
Yeah.
Make a strength check at disadvantage.
Okay. It's not poison, right? It's just like her own special effect.
It's just a rank odor.
Yeah, all right.
It's just super
it's
gross.
It's so rank, it doesn't even matter that you don't have a nose.
Ooh. Dang. Wow. It doesn't matter that I have disadvantage either. I go over there and like the metaphysical properties of smelling this without a nose are so interesting.
What did that two translate into on your strength roll?
That's six.
Oh no, six is not going to do it. So you got a very wet.
I don't have like a 26 strength. I've got an 18. Right. I have a thing I could be that's stronger than this, but it would not fit in this hallway.
And being wet just makes the odor even worse.
Being wet just makes the odor even more improbable.
And you're staying put there?
Yeah, I'm going to just try this again next turn, probably.
Now, a man comes out of this cell and is shoving his way through the crowd with...
Oh, could you do me a favor?
No.
Could you shift my token back up in size?
Why?
Because I'd like to visually indicate that I'm now larger, because it might mean that things don't try to, like, push past me in this hallway.
So are you trying to physically take up space? Because, I mean, they can just go through you. You're an elemental. You're made of water.
Yeah, they can go through me. It would just be unpleasant. Hopefully, they would rather not.
A lot of them haven't had a bath in probably years.
So I'm doing good deeds.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, we'll just say that for intents and purposes, you're taking up pretty much the entire hallway, essentially. It's about 10 feet wide. So to move through that square, you have to walk through Mahogany. And whether or not that's a pleasant experience, I will leave into the individual eye of the beholder. This man coming out of the cell, and he's pushing through the crowd much faster than you are, and it becomes apparent why. He has 7 arms. Other than that, he looks like a normal human. And it's very apparent that he's supposed to have 8 arms, but the lowest arm on the right side you see has been severed. It's just a nub with a worn bandage wrapped around it. And he's using the arms to shove all of these people aside, and he's eyeing Liberation very, very intently. Liberation, make a... Oh, I have to make an attack roll against you.
Make a friendship roll. Perhaps.
Make a strength saving throw. I actually don't have to make an attack roll against you. I roll all these rules myself and then forgot all of them.
16.
Coming out of this cell, tearing ass out of this cell, is a rogue Modron. And he's shouting over the din of the chaos, repeatedly shouting, "Error! Error! Error! Error!" And this Modron has all sorts of weird things, like, bolted and welded to his frame. Like, there's a teapot on top. He's got a flat iron on the side. He's got, like, a large wrench just welded in place. And he comes blasting out of the cell and throws his physical form into you and tries to just knock you onto the ground. But you don't. You stand fast. He just bounces off of you and is continuing to press into you, shouting, "Error! Error! Error! Error!"
I can't believe I didn't do this
comment. Would you describe his alignment as lawful?
I would describe his alignment as error, 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 error.
That's why Modrons are the best characters in this game.
Riot, you're up.
Okay. Riot touches Kelian and says, "Actually, fuck this," and casts
casts Dimension Door.
Oh, all right. I had two things.
Where are you dimension dooring to? Just
the office that Negwe showed us on the way in.
Okay.
You said that was that D or E?
It was actually probably offside here, because this is the main admissions room, and then these are series of offices and things.
Okay.
Back here.
This is the closest Riot is comfortable coming to it. Because she doesn't know what's inside.
D and E are basically storerooms on each floor, and then F and G One is a kitchen, and one is like a break room for the bleakers on duty, of which right now it's just Negway. They're woefully understaffed.
All right, so which one was Negway in?
You were speaking to Negway originally, probably in this room here.
Okay, then but, I'm comfortable getting in there.
Okay. If
they're... I just don't want to teleport into a room I haven't seen.
Gotcha. If this place were staffed properly, there would be bleaker workers in both of the F and G rooms on each floor.
Mm-hmm.
But right now, there's nobody but crazy people.
Yeah.
Speaking of crazy people, this door is closed here, but just on the other side, filling up A and spilling out into the courtyard, you can hear just the mass of crazy Barmies going nutsack.
Oh. Huh. So I was thinking that might have been confined to the second floor, but now we know it's the first floor, too.
No.
So I'm presuming Negway already knows that this is going on.
You don't see hide nor hair of Negway anywhere. In the office, you're the only ones in there, and you still see the Giphod file rolled out on the desk, and...
Riot takes that.
Just snatch it up?
Yeah.
Right, go ahead and add that to your sheet. You have officially robbed the only charity in Sigil.
Nope, she's got her charity, the fake charity that turned into a real one.
Okay. And is that the end of Riot's turn?
Yeah. Well, I still got movement left, I guess. I could go in. I could go out into A. Yeah, that seems like a good idea.
Now I need to get my DMG open to the madness table.
Error is my favorite.
Error.
I'm glad I have a new friend.
I'm a little surprised there isn't an NPC called Mimic.
Mimics are immune to insanity. They can't go mad.
Ah.
No, it's a guy named Mimic who appears behind Kelian and bites him.
Nich, how about you roll a percentile die?
Okay.
And Nodal, how about you roll a d6? And don't roll a 5 or a 6.
Well, what if I want to roll 5 or 6?
Okay, fine.
Always roll high. 4.
Green is 10s. Eighty-three,
and what's that D6?
4.
And two of you are not in the room anymore. Okay. Serenity. One of the just massive Barmies that's filled up the hallway. One of them gets real close to you, grabs you around the chest, and is just saying, "You're my special friend. I can't believe everyone else can finally see you. I can't believe you're actually here. It means I'm not crazy after all." You won't be able to take another action until you deal with this Barmy that's grappling onto you.
Okay.
And then, from this cell here, emerges an old Githzerai, who's dressed in what once would have been a nice blue robe, but I mean, he's been here for many years. And without saying anything, he begins throwing rays of frost into the mass. And you see, quote-unquote, innocent Barmies falling dead around him.
Oh my god, it's Eldum's arch nemesis.
Wow. Liberation. You get to deal with Giphod. He comes out of his cell, cackling maniacally and saying, "Everything has gone according to my plan. Today is the mighty day of my emancipation, and now I will smite you with my infinite power." Does a 9 hit?
Nope.
No, his he just starts banging on your shoulder ineffectually with his closed fists. And it is now 5 rounds until...
Pet Giphod on the head.
The
that was cute.
Back to Serenity.
The Yogg.
So what kind of action is it to free myself from this Barmy?
It's just a use of your action. Just brush him off.
So a strength check then?
No, just declare you're doing it. I mean, there's... It's like, imagine a small child is latching onto you.
Sure. I mean, I can brush them off, and I can't really do much else right now, unfortunately.
That takes your action.
I'm going to assume that Eldove has this waterway well in hand.
No, Mahogany is the waterway.
I think Mahogany is Eldove's arch nemesis at the moment.
I'll move to there, but I can't take any further actions, so.
Okay. Liberation.
I'm going to give Error a hug.
Ice blood.
Give Error a hug.
And I'm going to say, you should really go back inside your house. And I'm trying to be nice and convince him to go back into his house.
You mean Gifad or Error?
Error.
Okay.
And he just replies, Error.
What I was attempting to do was use my faction bonus to convince him to go back into his room.
Typically that would work, but he is irretrievably insane.
Okay, then I'm just going to go ahead and try and...
Well, what's the name of the area that we're in right now?
The criminally and irretrievably insane wing.
Oh, okay. Got it.
All right, so I'm just going to go ahead and push Airwar back into his cell.
Okay.
And close it. Hopefully.
Go ahead and make a strength check.
That is an 16.
A 16 doesn't do it.
Damn. Now,
you have to remember, a rogue Modron weighs 300 pounds by default, and he's got a bunch of metal shit bolted onto him.
Mm. Okay.
Well, so you're not able to push him back.
Darn. Okay, no problem.
I'm going to watch, we're all going to watch as the PCs are all squashed in between Error and this wall of water over the course of the next few rounds. Moving or staying put?
Staying put.
Okay. The mother pushes through the water that is Mahogany to stand next to Serenity, continuing to beseech her to help with her ill child. And she's wondering why you're not offering any aid. How heartless can you possibly be?
Since she moved past me, can I use my reaction to grab her?
Sure, you can make an attack roll against her. Use your reaction attack of opportunity.
All right, but like, to be clear, it's a grab. I'm not slamming her. I can do that, right?
No, yeah, you can grab or shove or whatever. You don't have to actually do deal damage.
Yeah.
This is Error's favorite session ever that he's watched. I'm sure.
10?
I'm sorry, you said 10?
I said 10.
Now, what's your goal? Are you trying to just restrict her movement, or are you trying to shove her into one of the cells?
Shove her into one of the cells.
Okay, which cell?
Well, she's right here, so let's put her right here.
Okay. You can shove her in there, but you're not going to be able to close the door until your
turn. Yeah, I'll close the door on my turn.
Gotcha. No problem. And as you're pushing her in there, I mean, she's crying out hysterically, why won't anyone help me and my baby? Let's see. That's going to bring us to Kelian, downstairs in the office here.
Describe this office to me.
It's actually a series of offices. Like, we just can't see little individual rooms here. There's probably two or three offices in this area. It's a tiny space. It's not really a desk as much as like a counter with a little chair behind it that Negwe was sitting at. Behind him are just little like wooden cubbies. Like you'd see like a mail shelf in an old-timey hotel. You follow me?
Yep.
Got it. And so, just crammed with hundreds and hundreds of different files.
All right.
I know what Keelan's going to do.
Okay.
Pull out a cigarette, light one up.
Okay.
And starts pulling, going through the files, see if he can't find anything pertinent on Gifad.
Okay.
Which is what Megwe was supposed to do, but then something about shit and fans, I don't know.
Make an investigation check at disadvantage. DC is 20.
Don't worry, guys. I got this.
Don't takers give advantage on paperwork?
Well, this is very disorganized paperwork, so.
Nah. You don't find anything useful. In fact, as you're rummaging through the first few cubbies, you see there doesn't seem to be any rhyme or reason to this filing system. Mahogany. Wall of water, it's your turn.
Yeah. I'm going to try to close up this door, first of all.
Okay, and you can close it.
Okay. And then I'm going to book my way over to here to... God, for right now, I think I'm just going to, like, block off the The Barmy mass.
From, like, trying to prevent more Barmies from getting to your allies, or trying to prevent those Barmies from escaping?
From getting to my allies.
Okay. And the seven-armed man continues to push his way through the crowd towards Liberation. Liberation, make a strength saving throw, DC 16.
Oh, there I failed.
And once again, error, and he crashes into you, knocking you to the ground. And then he
clambers over error.
On top of you. And his next target will be Gifad.
I have a 300-pound block of thing.
He's not literally standing on you. He's standing, like, over you. If he was standing on you, I would apply crushing damage. Riot, what's good with you?
Riot is going to go back in outside into this foyer area.
Out into the courtyard?
What is going on out here?
Okay. It does seem as though a few of the Barmies have made their way out here.
Mm-hmm.
But at first glance, it's kind of difficult to tell who were patients here and who were just part of the huge line of visitors waiting to see the admissions man. Because a lot of them are hivers, and they don't look any better than the Barmies here.
Yeah, that's true.
You also see a couple of bleakers here and there, like, just starting to notice the situation and trying to get a handle on it from the outside.
Yeah, and Brian call out them, hey, suspend the whole criminal wing's open.
Okay, and you get the attention of a couple of bleakers who start running in your direction. In fact, I'll spawn them in if you want.
All right, sure.
I'll name them if you want.
You can't. They're just generic bleaker number one and generic bleaker number two.
See, that's actually literally their name, though. Because they decide that names are meaningless and don't really show the real person.
Does that end Riot's turn?
Yeah.
Okay. Somebody else roll the D100 this time, and somebody else roll the D6.
I'll roll the D100.
I'll roll the D6 again. I don't play by any rules but God's.
51.
51?
It's actually 50.
I said green one was the 10s.
And what's the 6? Okay.
3.
Liberation.
Hey.
One of the other people, one of just the massive Barmies, who's been shouting about how he's tired of everyone judging him all the time, how you're always casting glares at him like you're better than him, and he descends on your prone form. And is just, he's holding you to the ground and shouting in your face, and his spittle is splashing against your eyes and mouth. So it's going to take an action just to move him off of you before you do anything else next turn. And this sorcerer continues to cast Ray of Frost, and there's several bodies laying in his wake as he makes his way several steps down the hall towards you. Gifad is going to turn around and attack Serenity, shouting about his glorious emancipation, etc. Is a 14 going to hit?
No.
And again, he doesn't have a lot of strength to him. He's malnourished and probably kind of weak to begin with. And that's going to bring us... Oh, wait a minute. 4 rounds until...
Am I still in the range of the melon?
No.
No, the door, even if you were, the door's closed now.
Okay. I will, Serenity is going to shout to Mahogany, do something about that mage, and then grab Gifad, action transfer advantage on strength checks, shove him back in his cell, and close the door.
Okay.
In Aquin, Mahogany responds, I'm a water elemental!
that's a bad strength roll.
Good. No, it's not.
I'm hearing, I imagine we're all just hearing the same blubbing that Octodad does in Aquan.
That would be a 9.
A 9? DC is 10 for the regular Barmies. Wait, how does Serenity get a 9 with advantage on a strength?
Rolled a 4 and a 2.
Loud, frustrated blubbing.
So, you do not manage to move Gifad back.
Can I interpose myself between Error and Gifad? with my movement that I haven't taken yet?
Sure, if you want.
I will do that.
Go ahead and switch spaces with him real quick. Are you just trying to prevent him from getting blasted by this Motron?
Yeah.
All right. Is that end Serenity's turn?
Yep.
Liberation, you're having a real bad day right now.
Yeah, I'm gonna shove the guy aside as my action and then half my movement to stand up.
Okay.
And
an error standing next to you in the hallway now.
I don't want to shoulder check, but I don't want to like seem like I'm attacking the dude. I just want to see if I can block puzzle this guy into the cell that
well, he's you don't have to. An action to use anymore.
Yeah, you're right. So never mind. That's my turn.
Not gonna move?
Nah.
Okay.
And you just hear banging from the mother's cell. She continues to beseech for help. Wall of water. Wait, no, Kelian is next.
I'm assuming it's not going to get any easier trying things in these offices, right?
No, it's going to be that same DC.
Same check. Okay. What's happening in room A over here?
Room A is the main admissions area. This is where people kind of line up to see the admissions clerk. And again, like Riot, it's kind of hard to distinguish between who are the hivers here for visitation and who are the actual Barmies spilling out. But you do notice that these two doors are wide open.
Aha! All right. Well, in that case...
These doors required a key when you went in.
Yeah, Kelian will try to go over here and slam the door shut.
And pull the door shut?
Yeah.
Okay. Go ahead and make the strength check to push the Barmies out of the way first.
That is a 15.
Okay. So you do manage to close the doors, but these ones do not automatically latch when you close them together. They do require the key to turn in the lock.
Okay.
So,
well,
Barmies will be able to push them open on their next turn.
Okay. All right. Bonus action, take a sweet, sweet drag of my cigarette.
Wait, which flavor was that one?
Menthol.
I have a great smoking story that I'll tell during the break. Remind me. It's pretty good. Okay. You'll enjoy it.
We have a couple.
Our wall of water.
All right. So Mahogany empties his mind of all the reasons why this isn't the right form to him to be in, and instead focuses on why this is the correct form for him to be. And which of these is the mage?
Mage is way back here. He's the blue one.
All right. Mahogany's going to flow his way over there.
Remember, you only get half from your movement right now.
I think I can move through enemies.
Can you? In that case, you can take your full movement if that's part of the stat block. I mean, they're not really enemies, but we'll count them as enemies for purposes of this movement.
Yeah.
And I mean, you're moving past, I mean, a lot of this, the mass of Barmies, a lot of them are prone to violence themselves. They're fighting amongst themselves. There's bloodshed and injuries and death all around you.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a dash, and I'm going to enter this guy's space and fold myself around him. Basically, like, what I'm trying to do is cut off his access to anyone else, so if he wants to fire off a ray, he has to hit me.
So you're going to try to just be the, like, an absorption shield for the ray? Okay. Now, if you're going to completely engulf around him, you are, in essence, drowning him. Is that your intention?
That's why I want to be like a cylinder around him.
So, like, kind of just, like, leave his head sticking out?
Yeah.
All right, so you're not drowning him, but you want to prevent him from firing off rays. I get you.
Yeah, if he does want to fire off a ray, I mean, I can't prevent that statistically, but there is a fun effect that will happen if he does do that.
I see where this is going.
Yeah.
All right, Liberation.
That's me.
Make a strength athletic check.
I'm trained in those.
You don't have to roll very high on this particular roll.
That's 16.
16.
No, 14.
So you have like what, a bandolier with silver tipped darts?
Yeah.
And this seven-arm klepto just reaches out and tries to grab onto this bandolier and rip it off of your form. And you're like, hey, man, back off. That's not yours.
Yeah.
And he does not manage to steal it from you. But okay. He's certainly going to keep trying. Serenity, I need a strength saving throw. DC 16.
You might be better at this than I am. Oh.
Nope.
You're just not getting the strength today. It's just, well, error, error, error. As you are flattened to the ground, as the Modron just crashes into you and knocks you over. Riot, what are you doing down here?
Riot's almost clear of the whole place.
Riot's already thinking of a new band name.
Riot left the three hardiest members upstairs. Like, she, as far as she's concerned, they're good. All they've got to do is just amount of Barmies, and two of them can move ridiculous distances, and Serenity can just shrug off whatever happens between her
Serenity
and
Serenity can also move ridiculous distances. Yeah. She's a barbarian.
She doesn't know that none of them are actually doing this.
So Riot's mindset is just like, whatever, just get the hell out of Dodge.
Yeah, this seems like a really bad situation.
Problem solved.
So is it your intention to just leave the premises and get away from the gatehouse?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, who wants to roll the percentile this time? And who wants to roll the D6?
I want to roll the percentile. D6. I've always rolled the D6.
I'll roll the D6 this time.
I think we should make Nick roll it.
I rolled the first one.
I got the percentile then.
Okay.
Oh, no, I got it. Oh,
right. You can have the D6.
Go ahead. I took it out for you.
Oh. Okay, then I'll roll the D6.
That's a good number.
What's the percentile?
Three. Two. Oh.
Two. Now I will roll a D6 on my end. Kelian, you suddenly feel a huge weight on your shoulders as two of the Barmies next to you, both old haggard women, and they've been bickering just out of your earshot, but now they've suddenly taken an interest into you, and they begin begging for a drink, for a drop of ale or wine, and they are so distracting as they constantly just circle around you that it's going to take an action to shove them away before you do anything else.
It would have been way funnier if that happened to Mahogany. You start begging this water elemental for a drink.
The Winter Sorcerer is indeed going to fire off his Ray of Frost.
I don't think he can miss me. Like,
no, he can't. I'm just going to declare it an automatic hit.
Yeah, he can't miss. So I freeze around him.
You should probably roll a die to make sure it's not a crit.
So, do you still take damage? Oh, you know, I will do that. Make sure it's not a crit. Good call.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no, it's not. It's a hit. It's a save DC. So go ahead and make a save versus the Ray.
Oh, weird. Okay.
It's a dexterity save. Make it a disadvantage because you're entirely around him.
Yeah. I open up a hole around it.
Well, if you open up a hole around it, it's going to shoot through you and hit another
exactly.
Burner.
Exactly. That's not what I want.
You can willingly fail saves, right?
You can willingly fail it if you want.
Yeah, I'd rather take the hit.
Okay. So, what is your status as far as cold damage goes?
So, I don't take double. But I do freeze around him.
Okay, take 12 points of cold damage as the water around his arms freezes in place.
Yeah.
And let me make sure that actually will stop him from casting the spell.
It shouldn't. That, like, mechanically, it won't.
Well, it will if it requires a somatic component, which it does. So, no, you cannot cast it anymore.
All sucks to be
nice.
Well done, Mahogany.
He starts begging for release because the only way that these peons can ever know true madness is to become as cold as he is. And he's saying really this while encased in an ice elemental, essentially.
Yeah.
Which you could have cut out the middleman and just become an ice elemental to begin with.
Right, that was me not thinking.
Cypher penalty.
And yeah, Giphy can roll at advantage against Serenity. She's on the ground and she reckless attack. How does a 17 do?
Yeah, that hits.
Take 1 point of bludgeoning damage.
Okay.
Giphy starts pounding on your head and neck.
That still keeps my rage going. That's good.
It's like a nice massage.
Screeching about how he's going to smite you with his indescribable power. Now it's three rounds until... All right, Serenity, you're up.
No, you're down. You get a...
Okay, so it's an action to push the error off of me?
Yes. Well, no, he's not sitting on top of you. You're just laying prone, so it doesn't cost an action. Okay. It costs half your movement.
So half my movement to stand up, and then make another attempt to get Giphy in his cell and get it closed.
Okay, don't fail this one. That would just be embarrassing.
Well...
It's even worse than last time.
Was that your home?
Oh my god.
We must be meant to have him, Serenity.
This is the most resilient weak sauce Barmy in the gatehouse.
I'm pretty sure that's all Serenity's actions.
He's the swolest Barmy.
I think we just got the title for the session.
You owe all of us an apology. That's going to bring us to liberation.
You owe
turn.
Me money.
Okay, so I'm thinking that error is not the way. So I'm going to see about getting Gilgamesh here into this cell.
Pushing Glorgamorsh into the cell. Okay.
Yeah.
Make that strength check. DC on this one's only 10 because he's Glorgamorsh.
Glorgamorsh is actually pretty strong. That's only an 8.
When I put this encounter together, I was not expecting you guys to fail so bad at these strength checks.
Do you know us?
So I mean,
me alone being in this party.
You're trying to push him back, but something about him having a 5-arm advantage over you.
Well, the thing is, a man with 2 arms has a fighting chance. So with 7 arms.
Yeah. I don't know. Maybe I'm barking at the wrong tree here.
That's gonna bring us to Kelian downstairs because the mother is in her cell.
And there's two women on me.
Yeah, she's gonna take an action to basically shove them away.
Yeah, I'll do that.
Okay.
Shove on, blow smoke in their face and shove them away.
Very good. And what's next?
6 spray.
I guess that's it because all I can do is move, right?
Sure. I mean, you also have a cunning action because you're a rogue.
Yeah, but my cunning action only lets me do... Like, I don't want to hide. That seems...
Rioted.
I know, but...
So are you moving anywhere or staying put?
I'm staying put. Okay. Because this next action is going to try to be to close the doors again. What are these guys up to?
I guess I didn't put them on the initiative order, but they're starting to investigate
what's
happening. They're starting to come inside. You see them digging on their persons to see if either one of them has keys to these doors, but it looks like neither of them do at the moment.
Oh, great. All right.
Ice cylinder.
All right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to kind of pull him with my body, which I guess is normally how pulling happens. This is just more so.
Now that you're solid, I am going to restrict your movement, though, because you do have to push the enemies aside.
My movement is very restricted. I can only move 5 feet.
Oh, well, yeah, that's fine.
Yeah. So,
take
well, it's 10 feet cut in half is 5.
Yeah.
Frog so I'm going to just pull him into a cell.
Just pull him in here?
Yeah.
Okay, very good. Is that all you're doing?
I kind of want to...
You still have an action, basically.
Yeah. Can I pull back enough to close the door? Like, do I have to spend that 5 feet again to get out of the cell?
Yes.
Okay. Then, I'm good.
Liberation.
Hey.
Make a strength athletics. Oh, you gotta roll better this time.
That is a 13.
A 15 is not going to do it. As the seven-armed man snatches your bandolier of darts and then runs full speed away from you.
Oh, shit. Shout out. He's got weapons now.
He's got... He can throw seven per round.
Yeah.
I gotta say, this is on you.
Liberation, make a strength saving throw.
I am proficient in those. Alright, yeah, that's good. That's a 24.
Alright, so Error crashes into you, but does not knock you prone.
So now he's just, now he's like a mosh.
Error hitting. Crashes, you said?
So Ryan, are you, you're gone? We don't have to come back around to you again, or did you have something in mind?
Last action message to Kelian. Time to get out while the getting's good.
Kelian, you do not receive that message.
Okay. Bye.
Because he is standing within the confines of the criminally and irretrievably insane wing.
Fair enough.
Alright, so I went ahead and just deleted all my darts.
Well, I mean, you can get them back if you chase the guy down and beat him to death, maybe.
Yeah, no.
Alright, who wants to roll the percentile?
I will.
And who wants to roll the d6?
I'll roll the d6.
Oh, I can roll d4 now, actually.
D6 is a 2.
Percentile is an 84.
Serenity, your good friend, who continues to declare that you're the only one he can trust, and he's so happy that everyone else can see you, once again, latches onto you and restricts you from doing anything. He's going to take an action to shove him aside. Mahogany.
This is absurd.
You want
to...
Do you want to automatically fail the save again?
Yeah.
Okay. Then you're going to take some more cold damage. 17 points of cold damage.
Okay.
And then you freeze even more.
Yeah. Well, refreeze.
No, you know what? No, scratch that. He's not able to cast because you're...
No. I unfroze at the end of my turn, then he froze me again.
Oh, okay. That's fair.
Yeah.
And Gifod, who I still cannot believe is not in his cell, is going to attack Serenity again. Does a 14 do it?
No.
Alright, then you take zero damage as he's... I mean, he's still yelling about how powerful he is and how he's going to smite you all and you all kneel before him. And now it is two rounds until... Alright, Serenity, are you going to put an end to this now?
I'm pretty sure the only thing I can do this turn is shake the guy off.
Shake the guy off? Moving or staying put?
Shake.
I kind of like where I am.
Do you really?
Well, no, but it's better than the alternative.
She's accustomed to it.
I have a good alternative to where you are.
Liberation, what are you doing?
I'm going to go see if I can get my darts back.
Okay, do you have enough movement to get all the way down there?
I have 50 feet of movement, and that's 25.
That's fine.
Yeah. And 25 with difficult terrain, so I'm pushing past Barmies and... Say, like, hey, that's mine. Give it back, please.
And by the time you get to him, he's already lost interest in the darts and has dropped them on the ground and is eyeing the other stuff you're carrying.
All right, I'll pick up my darts and then key point to get some more movement back and shove right past those Barmies again.
Okay. You going to take an action at any point?
Yeah, I'll see if I can't get Error into a cell.
Okay. It's going to
be hilarious.
A more difficult strength check. Go ahead and make that.
Can I do athletics for that, or...?
It's going to be straight strength. This is brute physical force.
That is a 16.
A 16?
Yeah.
Does not do it. And he just continues shouting, Error! Error! Error!
I basically wanted another Error.
Kelian, what's good with you?
All right, so describe to me what the situation with this door is.
Right now, it's closed.
Right.
But it could be open from the inside very easily.
This side can open it, and these two chuckle fucks over here are just like, we don't have keys. Like,
well, right now, their attention are dealing with the people in this room. Like,
okay.
They seem to have an intuitive knowledge of which of these people are Barmies and which of them are hivers here to visit. And they're currently set to the task of separating them out, getting the visitors out into the courtyard to safety.
That sounds like a good idea. Mm-hmm. All right.
Are you going to... You're just gonna leave?
Yep. Get on out. Walk on out of there. Like,
yep. The part that sounded like a good idea was getting the visitor, namely him, outside to yep. save life.
Okay. Is that the end of your turn?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Mahogany, you're up.
All right. I'm going to slide my... Well, I was going to say my slide my ass, but I don't really have one, out of this cell and shut this door.
Okay.
If you want me to...
There's no check needed because, I mean, he's already in the cell.
He's already in the cell.
And
yeah.
Closing the door doesn't really take an action, so you can still take an action if you want.
Yeah. Well, I think I'm going to spend my actions getting back to the party, and then I'm going to bonus action to heal myself up.
Okay.
So I took some damage.
He's a pretty potent raise there.
He's a pretty high level wizard. Liberation.
Hey.
Let's see a strength athletics check.
Twenty-one.
And the seven arm klepto lashes out and gets his greasy fingers on your journal and tries to wrench it away from you.
Oh no, sir.
But he does
not
manage to take it. You spin around and it stays in place.
No, sir. That is my journal. That is the one thing that I'm not losing here.
That's the one that Aunt Nancy marked, isn't it?
Yeah. The journal was is the Elsie clone journal.
Okay.
Like, you won't be able to write anymore.
Yeah, I won't be able to get bonus experience or let any of you chat people know about my crazy thoughts.
I also need you to make a strength saving throw, Liberation.
Oh yeah, because of error. That's an 18.
Okay, you're fine. He does not knock you prone. Riot's gone. She's the only smart one here. Who wants to do percentile this time for the mass of armies?
I'll do the D6.
Someone else do the percentile. I did it last turn.
I'll do it. I love rolling percentile. It's so bad. 88.
And the D6 was a 1.
Now there's only three of you still in the shit here. Liberation.
Hey.
One of the massive Barmies, a young half-elf woman who's just cackling hysterically. She finds this situation so infectiously funny, and she can't believe you're not laughing, and she's trying to explain to you through her hysterical cackling why it's funny. And she latches onto you, grabbing on your shoulder, like resting on your form. And it's going to take an action to be rid of her.
Yep. Okay. Could I key point action to get to do that?
You can spend a key point to do anything your key points say you can do.
Okay. All right, then.
If you kill her with a flurry of blows from a key point, she won't be holding you anymore.
That's true. You can. My ruling is, I will. You can declare a flurry of blows to be non-lethal if you want, but you can't change it into a shove or grab the way you can a regular attack.
Mm-hmm.
Because when I think flurry of blows, I think like you're doing like 100 punches or whatever.
Yeah.
Winter Sorcerer is out of the picture. I cannot believe Gifod is still standing, but since he is,
we're taking him with us.
He's yours now. Serenity, how's an 18 do to hit you?
That is.
Take 1 point of bludgeoning damage.
Okay, that's actually fine.
How is he still here? I have no idea. Now it's one round until... And I just want to point out that basically everybody's standing where they started at this point.
Yeah.
So, Serenity, top of the order with you.
Get you fought back in his cell. Well, that's a 14.
Okay, which cell do you shove him into? Into his?
The one that he was in, yeah.
And he cries out the whole time about how powerful he is. And, you can't do this to me, and you will come to rue the day when you have crossed paths with the powerful... What
and
was
I'll
it?
Tell the rest of the group we should get out of here.
10, 20, 30,
40. That's the end of Serenity's turn.
And that's with your half movement?
I already said the end of my turn. Yeah, that was with my half movement.
Okay. And Liberation.
All right, so once that happens, I'm going to go 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Keep standard action for another 50. Gets me to here, and then key point, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50.
Okay.
Dragging the old woman the whole way?
Oh, yeah. No, so never mind. Never mind. Strike that. That 100 is right there. 10, 20, 30.
You can still use a bonus action to key point, I think, can't you?
Yeah, he still has he can still make two moves.
Yeah, I can still do that. I just have to burn a key point for it, and so that's what I'm going to do.
Okay, Kelian, are you just gone?
Oh, he's staying in the courtyard. He doesn't stay
in the courtyard. Are you taking any actions, or are you just watching it all unfold?
If there's bleakers to guide inside and let them know what's going on, he'll do that. But otherwise, he's just going to watch it all unfold because.
Okay.
I have a sneaking suspicion of what's about to happen, so Kelian wants to be in the premises, just in case.
All right, Mahogany, what's good with you?
All right, Mahogany, hearing that we're on our way out, what's the way out of here?
The stairs are at the end of the hall, and then you've got to fight your way all the way down this hallway.
Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah, this is the second floor. It's sitting on top of this one here. I wasn't sure if that was clear from the map.
I'm going to use my movement to move here, and then I'm going to use my action to hold an action, and when the party moves forward, I'm going to move with them.
Okay. And you watch as you're running away, the seven-armed klepto gets his hands on the teapot welded to the top of Error and just trying to pry it loose from his head.
Yeah, I love how much that isn't my problem.
And Error knocks him to the ground.
Error.
See who wants to do the percentile this time and who wants to do the D6.
I'll do it. I'll do percentile. Right, goes flying too. 24.
24.
4 on the D6.
Liberation.
Hey.
As you're trying to make good your escape, one of the Barmys gets in the way, and you can see he's holding in his hands what looks like the ancient, just desiccated skeleton of a mouse or a rat, and he's extremely interested in showing this to you, in this treasure that he's found, and trying to explain the extensive value of what he holds, and that maybe he can cut you. And he's in your way. It's going to take an action to give you.
Yeah. Yeah.
And you hear Gifod continue bang on the door behind him. And we're now out of rounds. 0 rounds until. And we'll know what until is when we come back from break.